Miami zone.
No PowerPoint here. Okay, those of you who know, I got into this profession thanks to David Green, because I would have left physical therapy after paying NYU a lot of money, because I didn't feel like I liked the profession. So taking part B with Dana, I finally resolved 8 months of left upper trapezius neck, upper trapezius shoulder blade, where constantly I was searching for spots to relieve my trigger points, walking around with a Theracane. My ex-wife happily elbowed me. And as Dana is teaching the course and I'm trying to do what he explains and I'm in the sagittal plane, I'm getting worse. And I figured out, guess what? I saw the light. If I kept stretching to the right, which made me feel good, I never in my mind thought that going to the left is the answer. Who does? No one does. No one on this planet thinks that moving into the pain is the answer. The Kabbalah tells you that the answer in life are going into the dark and scary, but most people don't read the Kabbalah. So, when I started to go laterally, I started to feel a major change. But here's the problem. I needed sustained lateral flexion to resolve my problem. Now, when I watch TV at home, and I sit there, my TV is hanging to the right, and my whole living room is set like this. So after half an hour of sitting there, it's like bucking the hell out of me. It comes back. I'm like, okay, so it's really annoying to watch TV like this. So force alternative, fairly simple. I kind of change it, and when I lie, what I did, this helped me a lot. But then I changed the angle of the sofa, which really pissed off my ex-wife. And then I did this. So I added lateral flexion with rotation, and that seemed to be really good for you. So anyway, if it will help any of you with your patients, something to think about, because as we know, most of the damage occurs not in our office, but when they're home. Hopefully this will help you. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Steven, where's Steven? There he is.